Matt Daneman, business reporter for the Democrat and Chronicle, joins us. Great to see you.
I gotta say, Southern Tier Feral Pigs, great band name.
Okay, but not necessarily good to have around.
Not so
I don't
want
to run into one of those things. Let's start off with Eastman Kodak.
Been a very newsy few days for Eastman Kodak. A couple major developments with the company in the last few days. First off, they've reorganized sort of their managerial structure. If you remember back in January, and up until January, the company had been sort of a three-legged stool. Mm-hmm. It had sort of the traditional film business, it had digital printing, and it had consumer products. Then they went to just a strict commercial consumer two-armed sort of operation, saying this is more streamlined, more efficient, yada, yada, yada. Lo and behold, the company says, well, now we're even more streamlined by going back to a three-prong system.
Okay.
Where you've got, again,
so a lot of people are scratching their heads over this.
It's kind of curious. Kodak says that, well, this is all about making financial reporting more easy. Who knows? There's a lot of supposition out there. If there are other ulterior motives? Kodak denies that, for example, by this new reporting process, that it may make it easier to sell one of these business arms. Kodak says, well, no, that's not why we're doing it at all. You know, we're not going to really know what the whole reasoning is until some point in the future, if ever. Maybe it's just exactly what Kodak says, but it just creates a different way of how the company operates, and now they've got three people overseeing three lines of business as opposed to two. Reporting directly to Antonio Perez.
Some other news this week.
The other issue, a lot more controversial. Kodak has before U.S. bankruptcy court, requesting permission to spend anywhere from about $8.8 million to as much as almost $18 million, $17.6 million, for executive bonuses. These would go to the top 15 head, you know, corner office executive types, including Antonio Perez, CEO, and these bonuses would be tied to a few very key metrics. A, the company getting out of bankruptcy, and B, the unsecured creditors getting as big a payback as possible. It's kind of interesting. These kinds of bonuses are both not all that uncommon in Chapter 11, and they're also somewhat controversial. The United States tightened bankruptcy rules back in 2005 and made it more difficult to give bonuses for retention purposes for top executives, but a lot of companies now have gone to this process when they go into bankruptcy of here performance-based bonuses for bankruptcy. Whether this gets passed, this passes muster in bankruptcy court, remains to be seen. But it does more closely tie, or at least the goal is to more closely tie these top executives and what they're doing to getting the best returns possible for the company and for the people who are left with bills unpaid by the company going into bankruptcy.
So obviously a bitter pill for people who are not going to get money.
Oh, definitely. So if you're a retiree or an employee of Kodak, and perhaps you've seen your job cut, or you're seeing your, you know, fear of your benefits being cut, which almost surely is going to happen at some point, the idea that top executives might make out with some bonuses above and beyond their salaries, yeah, that's going to be a very large thing to swallow, a difficult thing to swallow. At the same time, the point of this company is to try to get out of bankruptcy
and provide incentives so that those executives don't jump ship prior to bringing the company out of bankruptcy.
Exactly. So it's easy to see how this could be a difficult thing for a lot of people to stomach.
All right, let's move on to consumer confidence.
Yeah, interesting sorts of things going on in the Rochester area. The new quarterly consumer confidence numbers for the Rochester area just came out from the Siena Research Institute. It does monthly New York-wide consumer confidence surveying and then does these quarterly numbers of the different metropolitan statistical areas. Rochester, New York City, we're all like walking down the street whistling Dixie. We're feeling very good about ourselves. Our consumer confidence for the second quarter of 2012, the highest it's been since early 2007, before the onset of the recession. New York City, the only place doing better in terms of confidence. Interesting counterpoint to a number of cities like Syracuse or Utica, where from the first quarter to the second quarter, their consumer confidence actually slid some. You saw other cities like Buffalo do the same as Rochester, where up from a year ago and up from the first quarter. it's not like we're feeling great according to these statistical numbers. Basically what it indicates is that a slight majority of people feel more upbeat about their personal finances and about the state of the economy than people who feel pessimistic. So it's not, you know, it's not like a musical where everybody's dancing and walking down the street.
Got about a minute left. Let's move on to the hotel scene in Rochester.
Yeah, a lot of interesting things going on in the hotel scene. Rochester Plaza Hotel, sitting just down the street from where we're sitting now, about to embark on what will ultimately be a $3 million renovation and revamp, which is, you know, significant kind of investment, but it comes at an interesting time when there's a lot of activity going on hotel-wise. You've got the Strathallan and the East Avenue Inn, both putting significant amounts of money into renovations and upgrades of those. Even more significant, there are financial plans afoot for a new 100-room hotel in downtown Rochester, which would be right at East Main Street and Stone Street. It's curious because it never seemed like there was a dearth of need for more hotel space, but we'll see what happens.
Okay, thanks so much. Have a great weekend.
Always a pleasure.
Matt Daneman, business reporter for the Democrat and Chronicle, and I'm Julie Philipp. I'm off next time, but Steve Dahl will be here. Have a great week.